Welcome. It is so great to have each and every one of you out here on the front lawn of our church. I'm Susan Hefner-Hewn. I am honored to be pastor here. And on behalf of all of the youth leaders, I just want to welcome you to this 30th annual live nativity here at Christ United Methodist Church. For 30 years, this church has been telling the story and has been inviting you to know of God's love and to know that this story is your story. We have a lot of youth who are doing this live nativity for the first time tonight, and they came by invitation, which is telling the story and inviting people to be in the story. So tonight, be a part of this story. Let it touch your heart. And let it confirm to you that you are indeed loved. Let us pray. O God of storytelling, the story that we are about to hear tonight never gets old. And it is a story that we need to hear over and over. So we give thanks that this is a story about you coming to be born in us, coming to dwell with us, coming to show us love. And for that, we do indeed give thanks. For all of the storytellers tonight, we thank you. And for the most precious gift, your Son, Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Thank you. A long time ago, in a city of Galilee named Nazareth, there lived a woman, and the woman's name was Mary. Mary was very kind and good, and she was also very special. One day, the angel Gabriel, who was sent by God, came to Mary and said,
"Do not be afraid, Mary. The Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women."
Mary was troubled by the angel's greeting, but the angel said unto her,
"Fear not, for thou hast found favor with God. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb, and bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus. He shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest, and of his kingdom there shall be no end."
Joseph did as the angel of the Lord had bidden him, and took Mary to be his wife. And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree that every man must go to his family city to pay his taxes. Joseph's family had come from Bethlehem. Although Mary was not great with child, together they began a long journey to Bethlehem, with Mary riding on a donkey, and Joseph walking at her side. Along the way, Mary and Joseph had to stop many times to rest. When they arrived at Bethlehem, the city was crowded with people who had come to be taxed. Joseph and Mary could find no place to stay.
They took him and fed them as they
last, that kindly innkeeper saw that Mary was soon to give birth, and felt sorry for her and Joseph.
I don't have room for you at the inn, but I know a stable where you can stay. At least there you will have a warm place to sleep.
Joseph thanked the innkeeper and took Mary to the stable. And so it was while they were there, in the stable beside the animals, the baby Jesus was born. Mary wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger filled with straw. On that same night near Bethlehem, there were shepherds in the field keeping watch over their flock. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were afraid. But the angel said to them,
Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy. Unto you is born this day a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. You shall find the baby wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger.
When the angels had gone away to heaven, the shepherds said to one another,
Can this be true? Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this that the angel has told us.
They hurried to the stable and found Mary and Joseph, and baby Jesus lying in a manger.
In a manger.
After this, the shepherds traveled about telling everyone what they had seen and heard. One night, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying,
"Where is he that is born the king? For we have seen the star in the east, and we have come to worship him."
And lo, the star appeared, and went before them, till it came and stood over the place where the child was born. And they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. When the wise men came in and saw Jesus, they fell down on their knees and worshipped him. The kings offered baby Jesus great gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Hark the herald angels sing, glory to God. Thank you.